because it's doing these practices for me. Only for me, though, not for you, not for anyone else, not for him, not for me. You know, for me, these practices worked. In other words, I think meditation took place within these practices, through these practices directly through these practices, so that every posture became meditation. What I mean by that is every posture became one point, there's a one point of it within every posture, but then the mind would become totally still within every single asana, every single posture, the mind would become still, and there'd be pure meditation in each posture. That's kind of yogi stuff. Yeah? So the postures themselves, the breathing and the postures are sacred to me. Because they work. Well, they work for me. That's all you can know. All that process, all that unfolding happened for me through yoga. Not my guru. He came later. He came after. Muktananda came after. But it was through the practice. And of course, then what happens is that your teacher, your guru, once that process starts to unfold, he'll guide you, or she'll guide you. Because they know the process. If you haven't been through the process, you don't know it. And it is a real process. There's no imagination in it. This world that we experience here now seems terribly unreal, like a total dream, once you experience a deeper state of consciousness, once you experience yourself, this is like a dream. It is a dream. This is the most superficial consciousness we've got, waking state. You don't have to do anything for it. You're born into it. It's just there. If you'll be any deal in the habit. Lots of deals do happen.